Katie Saul is a tough competitor. She's from Canada, and she comes to throw down. But she's stepping up tonight against the likes of former world champion Andy Nguyen. You know, one day you'll see her on the front cover of a fitness magazine. The next, you'll see her kicking somebody in the head and knocking them out, or taking an arm and breaking an arm. She is one of the gamest competitors in the female sport. She might be one of the meanest when that door actually closes. I love this fight. I'm a huge fan of the 105 pounders. Katie Saul versus Andy Nguyen. You don't want to miss this one.
This fight camp was really different from the rest. It was way beyond my expectations because I went out to Straight Blast Gym Ireland and trained with John Kavanaugh.
There's not a lot of footage of my opponent, and I really don't know nothing about her. I know that she's going to be kissing my fist. We're going to kiss each other's fists. But yeah, she's a good boxer. She's a southpaw, so I trained for that.
Andy's pretty tough in the sense that she has a lot of experience, she's got a lot of size, she's got a lot of grit, and she loves the show. I've been on an elite level for a long time, so people will just suggest that maybe I won't be able to hang with a veteran, but it's gonna be a good one.
The prediction is we are gonna have fun. She looks like she's a fun person anyways, but I think after shots to the face, after shots to the body, I think we're going to do shots at the bar afterwards.
Aside from my first fight last year, first pro fight last year, I found this to be the least pressure just because of my experience versus hers. This is sort of a win-win fight, pardon the pun.
I'm not a boring fighter. I think they're gonna see a new year, new me kind of thing. It's gonna be fun. That's all I came here to do, just to have fun. It's another day in the office.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the wonderful Winnevegas Casino Resort, Sloan, Iowa, King of the Cage and General Tire present this three-round bout in the women's atomweight division live on the KOTC Facebook page. Your judges scoring this bout, Chad Lunders, Jade Jobin, and Rodney Verhoef. After the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, Eric Carr. Introducing first, in the Lucas Oil blue corner, standing 5 feet 3 inches tall, official weight 105 pounds. She represents the Straight Blast Gym Ireland and Winnipeg Academy of Martial Arts. Ladies and gentlemen, from Dublin, Ireland, by way of Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, presenting the Queen of the North, Katie Saul. Her opponent across the cage, fighting out of our General Tire red corner, stands at 5 feet 4 inches tall, official weight 105.6 pounds. She represents the Karate Mafia and Fitness Edge. Ladies and gentlemen, from Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, presenting Andy the Creation Wynn. Once again, your referee in charge of this three-round women's bout, Eric Carr, now with the final instructions.
Ladies, we've been over the instructions. Protect yourself at all times. Fight clean. Touch gloves if you like to. Head back to your corners.
Thank you. Austin or Armand, I think you got it.
I need to connect with your punches then. Body head. Body, body head. Yes, body, body. Left hand, left hand. Yes, good. Good job. Body, body head. Yeah, go to the body right there.
Climb it out. Nice, Katie. Good
job.
Get back in the back to the fence. Yes. Get up.
Up, up, up.
All right, now you got it. Perfect. Now.
What are your legs doing, Katie?
Good. Finish it now. Finish it. I need a good round. Let's see, throw the leg up.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of women's atom weight action here in the Hawkeye State, we go to the judges' scorecards and all three judges at K-side, Chad Lunders, Dave Jobin, and Rodney Verhoef, score this bout exactly the same way. 29-28 for your winner by unanimous decision, the Queen.
Thank you.
Andy Nguyen. How do you feel after your performance tonight? I know it's got to be disappointing to lose a unanimous decision to anybody that's in front of you.
Yeah, Katie Sauls, she trained hard. I had a couple bad days. I had a good morning out because my dad died. But that's not an excuse. I congratulate her, and I'm going to owe her a shot. So I said that to you. I hope you guys enjoyed the show. It doesn't matter if you win or lose. You have to have fun what you do. Scam me.
You have a remarkable attitude, and for everyone here in the audience and everybody watching around the world on the internet, we give you our sincerest regards for your father.
Thank you.
Rest in peace, and we'll see you back in the cage soon.
Okay, bye.
Andy, the Creation Nguyen, and now we bring on the Queen of the North, Katie Saul. You look tremendous tonight. How do you assess your performance?
I want to thank Andy. I thought I was going to get interviewed first, but I found out her dad died, and then thought maybe the fight would be called off. And she took it anyway, so thank you.
Sorry.
So thank you for coming anyway. That's really tough. I just didn't know you, so I didn't say anything for you.
What do you go now with King of the Cage after this big win here tonight?
My first MMA match ever was a year ago today, and I lost to a top girl in this division. I lost to Lindsay Van Zandt too. I want rematches, but I think I have to earn that first, so whoever's next, I'll take the challenge and move forward, but I want to avenge my losses.
And you've got Ireland in your back pocket, it seems. That's something new. Talk us to go out that situation.
Curtis Brigham brought me up from the ground bottom, so he's been my coach for Canada for 8 years now. But I have an Irish descent, and I had an idol that lived in Ireland. And I also watched his coach very closely. And we went out and I fell in love with the country and the gym, and we were at our first camp. And I plan to stay there.
Well, you're certainly representing Canada and Ireland quite well with your win tonight. Keep up the great work. We got two more fights coming up on Facebook. Enjoy.